In this video, I'll use the Palmer Penguins dataset to demonstrate a few different ways to make a scatterplot in JASP. The first option, which is my preferred option, is through descriptives. Select your variables, and under plots, select scatterplots. Let's look at some of the default settings here. For graph above scatterplot, the default is a density plot. This is the smooth curve we see here. This represents the variable on the horizontal axis. We have the option of changing this to a histogram. Again, this is representing the variable on the horizontal axis. I prefer the histogram because I think it's easier to interpret. We also have the option of turning this off. For graph right of scatter plot, we have the same options. Again, the default is the density plot. And now this is representing the variable on the vertical axis. And again, we can change this to a histogram, or we can turn it off completely and we're just left with the scatter plot. By default, JASP includes a regression line. The default is a smooth line. This is the line of best fit for the sample data. I would not use the smooth line because I think it can be very misleading. Almost every plot is going to look non-linear. It can be helpful if you're exploring non-linear regression, which we will not be covering in this course. So for this course, I would not use smooth. I would always change it to linear. This will give you the linear line of best fit, which is what we're working with this week in the course. By default, JASP also puts a 95% confidence interval on here. That's the gray region around the blue line. You also have the option of turning that off. Another way to obtain a scatter plot in JASP is under descriptives, select correlation plots. This will give you histogram and density plot for each variable, along with the scatter plot with the line of best fit. The third and final way that I'll show you is under regression, classical correlation. Again, select your variables and under plots, select scatter plots. The density for variables options gives us the same plot that we got using the scatter plot option under descriptives. Statistics will add the correlation here. The default is Pearson's R, but you could also request Spearman's row or Kendall's tau. In this course, we're primarily going to be working with Pearson's R, though. And you also have the option of adding a confidence interval or prediction interval to your plot. Those are the three options that you'll have when you want to make a scatter plot. All of the scatter plots I've demonstrated here were bivariate, meaning they involved only two variables. But with any of these options, you can add more interval ratio variables, and you'll end up with a scatterplot matrix like this.